In a surprise development, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, sent the House on recess yesterday, barely a month after MPs returned from another 3 weeks' break. Although he explained that the recess is to facilitate sectoral committees to carry out oversight and monitor budget implementation, MPs have remained divided as opposition claimed that the House was closed by their refusal to call off the boycott. They believe their relentless demand for accountability of missing persons is the reason that forced the Deputy Speaker to buy time.
The Speaker of Parliament has reached an extent of closing up plenaries. To me, it's just an excuse because of the pressure from opposition and following the demands of opposition.
Some opposition legislators have vowed not to go for the oversight tours where they were sent by the Speaker until government explains why they have not implemented the recent recommendations made by Parliament, including the sacking of the Trade Ministry Permanent Secretary, who was indicted by Parliament on misappropriation of funds.
We are having a situation where you go as members of Parliament, burn your midnight candles, work throughout the night, come up with reports that never see the light of the day, until we get an explanation from the president.
However, lawmakers of the ruling government have bashed narratives traded by the opposition, saying the recess, which was sanctioned by the Deputy Speaker, had nothing to do with the current impasse in the House.
That if you go and demonstrate and you show that you can do this and that, people vote for you. At the end of the day, when you fail to deliver on that, now you are trying to do it on Parliament.
Sports activities, they are there. They are participating. So people should not take that. They boycotted. They did not boycott.
They justified a need for oversight tours, arguing that MPs need to familiarize with what takes place in the countryside, where most projects on which public funds are spent are situated.
If you don't go there, then how shall we check government? Because we must hold government to account.
The director in charge of communication and public affairs, Chris Obore, spoke out on the matter saying the recess is timely since Parliament is about to commence the next budget cycle and oversight is necessary. He slammed legislators who find difficulties in going to the constituencies, saying they have a big problem because they are facilitated by taxpayers to visit their constituencies regularly to monitor service delivery and gather issues affecting communities that can be addressed by Parliament.
When a member of Parliament complains that, you know, there are too many recesses, are they running away from their people? I thought this would be an opportunity to say, let me go back and understand how my people live on day to day, how they wake up.
According to Obore, the impasse in the House between opposition and government is not a crisis that can cause leadership of the House to lose sleep, but a common phenomenon that can happen in any other House.
There are walkouts in every parliament. It is one way the minority expresses their dissatisfaction.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.